the lower body foam rolling series. I want you to start at the base of your ankles down here. So we're going to work from the bottom of our legs to the top of our legs. So you're going to kind of come up and just roll. Use your arms to push back and forth. If you need the assistance of your leg, you can kind of put one to the side here. You're going to roll the inside of that calf muscle all the way up to the knee, back and forth. Any place that it's tight, you're going to just kind of hold, take some deep breaths, put some pressure on that spot. You're going to get the middle and then roll to the outside, turning that leg, hitting all areas of that calf. You're going to switch and do the other side as well. And then after you get both calves, you're going to move up from behind the knee and work from the hamstrings, so going behind the knee up to the hip, doing the same thing, rolling that leg, targeting the inner thigh. You've got your opposite foot planted in your arms, which are helping control the movement so that the leg that is on the roller is just kind of hanging freely. So we've got the inside, we got the mid hamstring here, all the way up to the glute. And we're going to roll to the side here, get the outer hamstring all the way up to the glute. I'm going to spend about a minute on each section. So about a minute or so on the hamstring, on the calf, a minute or so on the hamstring, and then you're going to move up to more the glute and hip area, get mid here in the back, so both feet are down, and you're going to turn, get the right side of that hip, and again a minute or so on each side. Make sure you go through, do the same thing on the other leg. All right, so you're going to come back, get this foot planted, make sure we get the calf on the inside there, mid, outside, go back up behind the knee. Get all sides of that hamstring, turning that leg in, and then making sure we go up and get the hip on that side as well. All right, so once you get the back side of your legs and hips, glutes, we're going to then come over to the front side. So particularly if you're having shin splints or pain in your calf area, you want to make sure that we get this front part of the shin here. So you're going to lay that here and you're just going to roll from the ankle to the knee. Again, getting the other side as well. Ankle all the way up to the knee. I've got one leg on the roller. The other leg is assisting the movement. And then we're going to come down and put your thighs starting at the knee. It's easier sometimes to go to your forearms here. We're going to again start on one side, rolling across that quad muscle all the way up to the hip. Anywhere that is tight, you just kind of hold, take some deep breaths in, good. And then we're going to kind of again roll and get the inside of that thigh. That one's usually not quite as tight. And then you're gonna switch and get the other leg. And making one leg just relaxed. The other leg is kind of help pushing the movement along. You're gonna do that all the way up to your hips for your lower body rolling.